Hi, John here. In this video, I'm going to take you through how I cleaned the lichen off our solar panels. So here's a bit of footage or photos taken, first one in September 2019. And you can see there's very little lichen buildup. October 2019, surprisingly, not much either. May 2020, again, just about start to see it. These sort of photos weren't taken specifically to see the lichen. They were just general photos that I took of the array. But here, this is April 2021. And you can just start to see on the bottom edges, certainly on the top row, over on the right-hand side of the old array, the sort of little white spots starting to appear. And that's basically the lichen. There's a couple of marks also on the couple of panels that you can see on the left-hand array, which is bird poo, so you can ignore those. But let's roll on a bit. The next one is from October 2021, and this is with a drone, and you can see quite clearly the lichen spots building. If you look there, most of them are at the bottom edge to start with of the frame, and then they sort of creep round up onto the edge of the face of the panel, and also you can see they're down the sides as well, down the edges, and I'll explain why that is in a minute. But there's also some across the whole surface of the panel, small little dots there. Each one of those little dots is lichen. This is July 2020. Once it's got hold, the problem is it just grows exponentially, not fast, so sort of like 1 or 2 millimeters a year in some cases, but it does build up because each spore, each area is expanding and adding new bits to it as well. So it doesn't actually take long for it to build up. You get a lot of lichen. Is it lichen or lichen?
Lichen. Lichen.
Lichen. Lichen.
Lichen. Lichen. Lichen. Lichen. Lichen. Lichen. Lichen.
US pronounce it lichen. UK pronounce it lichen, so you can amuse yourself with whichever ones you prefer, depending on where you are in the world. So I'm going to show you what it is, how does it form, and then, more importantly, how to remove it. If you've not seen it up close, this is what it looks like. It's quite hard and sort of scabby and expands slowly. There's various types of lichen, depending on where you are in the world, various different colours. And I found that it's actually a British Lichen Society, which is quite interesting. And I went on there to find out exactly what lichen is. And as it clearly says at the bottom here, lichen is not a single organism. It's a stable symbiotic association between a fungus and algae. And that's quite important, because what happens is that if you don't clean your solar panels, you get the algae build up, and then after that the fungi forms on the algae and starts to create the lichen. So it says here, can lichen be removed from growing on solar panels? Well, yeah, absolutely. Take away the algae and the lichen does not have a chance to grow. And algae on solar panels is not given the opportunity to grow if they're cleaned regularly. Bowed my head in shame. Though mine weren't cleaned regularly. This gives you a close-up on how tough lichen is to remove. This is on one of our Velux windows, and you can see there's a few spots of lichen there. I'm just rubbing it with my finger, and it just doesn't want to move. This is dry and hard. However, if you dampen it, as I've done here on the solar panel, you can see, even just with a finger, you can brush off the top part of the lichen to expose the green algae underneath, and it's a lot easier to remove. Now, I took that last shot when we had our solar panels repaired back in February. We had the scaffolding up. While it was up, I took the opportunity to admire the view, but also to clean our solar panels. Now, at the time, I've since got rid of this, but at the time I had this brush which fits onto the end of a garden hose, and the brush head is quite sort of firm nylon bristles, and there's also a rubber sort of scraper on the top there which you can use. I thought, perfect, that'd be ideal. It is a bit heavy to use, so it was fine from the scaffolding, but I got rid of it because there's no way I was strong enough to use it to clean all our solar panels from standing on the single-storey extension we've got, where I can actually reach the solar panels quite comfortably. But it was just too tiring to wield it. It was just too heavy to be able to successfully clean the panels. You do about three and then you're completely exhausted. But here's me cleaning the panels, had an on-off switch on it, which pumped water up through it. And this is just ordinary tap water straight from the outside tap. You see it gushing down there. So I'm cleaning there and you can see that it's actually removing the lichen. It's cleaning the panels a bit, but even if we turn over the brush and use the scraper, sorry about the camera work here, it's difficult to do with just the one hand. Even just with using the scraper, you just can't remove the lichen. It has to be done by hand or chemically. That's the only two ways you can successfully clean the panels. As you can see, there's still a lot of areas left. This is all damp. And again, when it's damp, you can get stuck in with your fingers or a scraper or what have you and give them a good clean. This was the second array that went up, which I've kept clean since it's been installed. And you can see they're perfect, nice and clean. This is one of the lichen spots that was nice and damp. And you can see they all build up along this bottom row here. That's because the water, when it rains, it sits on that bottom edge channel of the panel. And if you don't clean the windows, then you get an algae build up. It also spills over onto the sides of the frame edges. Same principle, that's why you get a lot of the lichen build up along the edge of the frame. So it's quite easy to clean if you can get to it. And there's the rub. If you've got scaffolding up, you can obviously easily clean them. And this is after I clean them. So much, much better. The video doesn't really do it justice. The bottom panel on this second array, these coming up here, are a lot cleaner because I was able to get to them all and manually scrape off with my fingernail to get rid of all of the lichen. What I learned from this is that just by using a brush, you can't get rid of the lichen. It needs something more aggressive than that. And you can see here just a repeat of that previous one, just a bit closer up. Dry lichen, almost impossible to remove. When it's wet, it is a lot easier. But again, it really needs to be done by hand or with chemicals or both. So this is on the Velux window again, we had a lichen build up on there too. It comes off with quite a bit of elbow grease, but it does all come off and remove it. Now during my research on how to clean solar panels, I learned that the solar glass, or glass in general, is very pitted, not a smooth surface, and this is a microscope view of the surface of glass. So the algae bonds itself onto all the holes and valleys and craters in the glass and forms a very strong bond, making it difficult to remove it, even by hand. As I mentioned about chemical being one way of doing it, so what I got hold of is some isopropanol alcohol, almost pure, 99.9%. And what that does is, once you put it on neat, and that will then kill off the algae and prevent regrowth. So the only option I had to get to the top array was a ladder and then a roof ladder up onto the ridge of our roof. And these images here, this bit of video, is me sitting on the roof of our house. This is the top row. These are the very top edge of the panels. And I went along here with the spray bottle with the alcohol in it, spraying as I went and rubbing away the lichen. And that still proved extremely difficult. Once you've sort of knocked off the surface fungi and left the algae underneath, because I'm guessing it had been on there so long and baked on so long, it was extremely difficult to remove. So I ended up buying a window cleaner's glass scraper, and this proved very effective of scraping up the glass. It does say when you sort of research this that it is not recommended to use anything abrasive because it can remove the anti-glare coating film on them. I thought, well, it's the lesser of two evils if it does start to remove the coating. You either leave the lichen on there, which still keeps growing, or you scrape it off. There's no other way of dealing with it. And from the apex, I could only reach sort of arm's length down the panel, so there was still sort of two-thirds of the panel that I couldn't get to comfortably. And I bought an extension pole with an angle joint on it. Combining all those together, I was able to then stand on the extension roof, spray the panels with water to get the lichen all nice and soft. And then it was just a case of working along those panels and just scraping off the lichen. It was actually very straightforward and very easy to do. The view you're looking at there is it's finished. Once I'd done that, I then employed my new soft water system. So these are the two resin-filled vessels. On the left-hand side goes to the garden tap, outside tap. And on the right-hand side, it goes to my new water-fed pole, which is carbon fibre, proper window cleaner's pole. And it has a brush head specifically for cleaning solar panels. And also that bar across the top, a spray bar as it's called, gives you a continuous spray of water over the top. So you clean as you bring the brush down, it sprays a cascade of water over the bit you've just cleaned and sort of washes it all away. So it's actually really, really good. But the important thing is using the soft water is that you end up with no water spots or water stains. And that was it. That is the panels all nice and clean and they look superb. Whereas previously you always saw some little spots of lichen clinging on for dear life. I've now put in the calendar a monthly cleaning schedule to clean the panels. Just a preventative maintenance clean now. So there you go. Any questions? Drop them down in the comments below. And I'll see you on the next video. All right, take care. Bye.